All right. Hello, everybody. It's Matt at Fisher Electronics. So this is going to be the first part of this video. One of our clients has got a nice project going on here in their backyard. Try to sum this up as best as I can. Putting in a pool right here, obviously. This area is all going to be landscaped. Over in that area, we're going to have his playset currently there. Is most likely going to move somewhere about where that mound is. About in this area, there's going to be a fire pit. This is all landscaped with paver stones. This is going to be his pool house. In this pool house, we're going to have a 65-inch, probably a Samsung outdoor partial sun terrace TV. There's going to be speakers on all the corners of the pool house. I'll come walk around and show you the... I was just out here pre-wiring this. We've got our speaker wire coming down here. Speaker wire is going to be, I should say, the speaker is going to be on the side of this post. Same thing back here to the left of that window, just down from that box beam. I should say boxed in, but speaker is going to be right about there. Now I'll walk around to the front side of the house and show you the same thing of where they will be. Before I do that, though, as I walk, well, I'll get to the front of the pool house. Kind of doing this on the fly. It is what it is for the video. Here's our speaker on this side of the pool house. It's going to be mounted down in this area, pointed obviously toward the front, maybe a little bit of a left angle to cover playset area. Fire pit playset's further down. We'll get to that. And here's the back speaker. Now, what we're going to actually do for speakers here. Previously, a few years back, we mounted four speakers on the back side of his house. I'll walk up there and show you. Those are 5 1/4 inch. Those four speakers are going to move to this pool house. Those are going to be replaced with 6 1/2 inch speakers. They give a little more punch, a little more sound. So there's one. There's the second. We just kind of put these here as he wasn't sure how he was going to do it, probably at least 4 or 5 years ago. So we just got general coverage for what we didn't know would possibly be here. There's the third, and then there's the fourth. Let me walk back and I'll show you this pool. There's a nice little hot tub there. There's deep end of the pool, shallow area. I'm going to walk back and get you more of a straight up shot of the house. But anyways, those four speakers are moving over to the pool house. 2 on the front, 2 on the back. They will be replaced with 6 1/2 inch. There you can kind of see them. 1, 2 in there, 3, 4. So out here, what we're going to do for audio in the landscaped area, he's going to have a speaker. This will be 70 volt out here. Speaker in his fire pit. A speaker in his playset area. 2 speaker about where that construction material is, but a little bit closer. Right about in that area, there's going to be a landscaped shrubbery in that area. 2 speakers in there. Those will all be 70 volt. And it'll be zoned appropriately to where he can have some on and some off as we set it up and as he chooses. So it's not all together playing at the same time. Conduit's going to be run from around the corner, and I'll show you our starting point. They've already started working on it, but conduit's going to be run into our pool house, and then conduits to the fire pit, to the playset, and then to the landscape speakers over there. Let me walk around and show you. His equipment currently is all in the house in his basement in a storage area. And I'll walk around here and show you where that is coming out. They've gotten to this point right about here with the trench, but that's going to have to come under here, and where we're going to have to all go in at here is about right here, where his water spigot vent comes out and exhaust. In this area is where everything's going into the house at. So if we walk back, you'll see it's going to travel along there and then head off to the pool house. Now, let me show you what we're going to do in the pool house at this point in time. kind of a fluid situation. Things can change, but at this point in time, pardon the wind if you're hearing a lot of that, 2 1.5-inch conduits run into this storage area here where I have our speaker lines going. I have right now the 4 speaker lines going to the 4 speakers, and then this will be our junction point in the storage area. He wants his equipment in the house, not out here. This is up in Ohio. You know, you can get boxes that are trying to be heated. The storage area is not going to be heated, so the best way to do it would be keep your equipment in the house. Internet line from the house and speaker line is going to be run here. That's why you see that cat cable. I just have it run over there to the TV. More like backup. I say that backup because when I say internet, he's also going to have one of his access points in the storage area from his house. He's got an Eero system. So if you're wondering why isn't it on the outside of the building, that would be why, because Eero does not make outdoor units. However, even with all the indoor units, he already has very good Wi-Fi coverage out here. We're just going to put another one in his storage area to maximize that so that there's no way he'd say, I got poor Wi-Fi. With that said, there will be another conduit coming to the Samsung 65-inch terrace. Again, I realized we could put an internet line in or anything we needed to that TV, but it doesn't hurt to have backup when the walls are open in case something happens, but it's better to be safe than sorry in these types of situations because, you know, once this conduit is all in, concreted, there's no going back. So I go by the rule of thumb, well, however that saying is, I go by better safe than sorry. So that's what we got here so far on this update. 4 speakers on the side, 65-inch Samsung Terrace there with a soundbar. Speakers out here and his fire pit, 1 speaker there, 1 speaker at the playset, 2 speakers in the landscaped area about right over there. And those 4 house speakers, the 5 1/4-inch, are moving to the pool house. Those will be replaced with 6.5. All right, guys. I will update you as we move along with this. And we'll see how it goes. See you next time. All right, everybody. Matt at Fisher's again, part 2 for this outdoor pool house, pool outdoor audio adventure. Been a few changes, but back to the house here. We'll get to those changes real quick. We've had our 6.5-inch speakers now on the house. Those were 5 1/4. We took those off. Like I said before, those are going to come to this pool house. So we've got our 6.5-inch speakers on the house currently. That's what we're going to use in this particular case for that. Now, the pool house, some of the changes in here. Our 65-inch, we found where center was, so we moved that to the left a little. That center is about that beam right there of where the TV will be. There's our conduit coming up for any wires, internet, anything of that nature. That's how we're going to get things to it if we were need to from our house. He added a 55-inch outdoor TV also, so that's where the 55-inch is going to go. We do have a conduit there coming up to that location. There it is right there. That's going to come up to that so we can get wires to that TV. One also thing that I said was a change. Initially, let me step around here and I'll show you. The future basketball court and bigger garage is going to go out in this area, not necessarily out over there where our truck is. So therefore, for the back speakers for his pool house, there's actually going to be one on the house at that corner. And then the other one is going to be right here. Initially, we did run a speaker line to that far corner down there. That's just going to be extra. In case he would ever want further sound down here, we can make that happen. But the speakers for the back of the pool house are going to be one right here at this corner under that pop-out beam, right about there. And then one on his house on this wall right over here. Not the brick wall, but on the siding.
pardon the construction equipment and everything. Contractors are getting the lines moving out to this point. They're going to come along here. One of the next steps that's going to happen is the lines are going to come along here and go in right around that to the right of the exhaust right there. I believe over in that area is where the lines, all those conduits are going to go in. So that's part of our conduits going to the pool house. There'll also be three additional, as I mentioned before, coming out of there to go to his fire pit for speakers, place that area for speakers, and far landscaping at the back of the pool for speakers. The far landscaping is about where that pile, that mound is over there, and those items. Place that right there is going to move a little to the left past the corner of the pool. Fire pit's going to be somewhere in there. All right, guys, we'll get you another update as we continue along. Okay, everybody, another update here at this project of the pool, outdoor speakers, and landscaped area with the playset, fire pit, pool house, all that sort of thing. So here's where we're at now. What we've done is we've gotten our conduits in before gravel and concrete goes in to this point, and it's going to continue around that side, but we've got our conduit into the three locations. This one sweeping around this corner is going to come all the way down here. This is 1-inch conduit, schedule 40 PVC. Going to come down here, and as you can see, it's sticking up down there. That is going to come for a speaker line to a couple speakers out here in a landscaped area facing the pool. A couple landscape speakers facing this pool direction. If the film's a little bouncy, my apologies, my bad. So that's that conduit taken off that way. Then we'll come around here. There's a bigger picture of the pool house, and the side of the house. Over in this area, this is where, well, I'm right next to it, if you can get an image. This playset is probably going to be moved to over here. There'll be a 22-inch wall on this side of that pipe, and that's where a speaker will be for the playset area. So here's another conduit heading along the pool here, and then again it wraps around and comes in about over there where it stops currently. And I'll walk along here. We'll meet up with these two after I go through this. This here is their fire pit. We're going to be out here. Again, another 22-inch wall will be right on that side of that, kind of wrapped around in a circle around this fire pit. So we'll have a speaker here pointed inward. With this, at least, you can add speakers to it. It's not a problem if needed. But this gets us aligned to these primary locations where audio would need to be out here. And we can take it from there. Got another, this conduit comes around. Here's that other one coming around. This is all going to be concrete in here. Comes through here. We did dig this out. Not sure technically it was needed, but we always like to make sure they're low enough so we're not pissing off contractors, foremen, landscape people. Let's get it done the best way possible. So the conduits come to here. They come, they turn. Right now they stop about here. Those three, along with those, and then we'll work with the general contractor. They're going to come around here, go around a turn there, and go into the house. Let me walk over there, pardon me. Come along here, go into the house, right in this area, over here. I believe it's on that side, but that's where they will go in to the house. So we can get lines from there, from our home location, where all the equipment will be. Okay, so that's going to do it for this update. And then you'll see this whole video once it's all done and complete. But we're just filming this as it goes along, as we progress through it on these jobs. Matt at Fisher Electronics, and I'll see you with another update on this job. All right, guys, isn't this a massive change? This is actually the next year, 2023.
So lots happened since the last update, but I think we left off with putting some conduits in, getting lines to different locations for their fire pit, which is over there, their playhouse there, and some landscaping around that corner. That's all in place. Pool house is pretty much completed. Heck, we even have a nice basketball court here. Outstanding, and there's going to be another garage building out over that way. But in this case, for our job of what we've got going on, again, our lines are in place for our system. We've got the speakers changed on the house. Those are now 6.5 inch, 4 speakers on the house. We just swapped those out with the others that were there. 1, 2, there's one there, and then there's one there. We're gonna have 2 landscape speakers in that area. Our pipe's already up with our wire ready to go. I'll show you that. We're in late April now. Here's our pipe out here. So when this landscaping comes in, we'll have our wiring. Wiring's already run in the pipe to our speakers out here. That'll be on a 70 volt system. The pool is in, has water. They added a diving board. It's gonna be very nice. This is our playset area. In this area, this is our pipe right here. With our line, we also ran another tracer line to where, hey, if anything else has to be run, we've got that line in there and ready to go. And then if we walk toward our fire pit, I'll show you that area. This is going to be outstanding when it's all finished up. Our line is right about here for our fire pit. Right here, there's our line for the fire pit. And again, that's gonna be 70 volt system also with another tracer in case anything new has to be run. Let's go take a look in the pool house. Just gonna jump over this barrier. In the pool house, we have a 55 and 65. Gonna be a slight change. The 55 is already on this wall, and today we're mounting the 65 here. Both of these are hardwired back to the house for internet. We do have a Wi-Fi mesh unit in here. It's in the storage room on the opposite side of this wall. Samsung Terrace with soundbar hardwired to the internet. There's also a line for that to get the audio of that into the Sonos system. So that's mounted there. That was originally going to be the 65, but because of that fridge right there, those doors opening, that fridge is gonna go left a little more. If the 65 was there, it would have butted up against it and wouldn't have been able to open the doors enough. So, change in design. 55 here, 65 here. We're getting that out right now, starting to mount it. As far as audio on the pool house, we've got our speakers mounted. This is almost all ready to go. They all are wired. Speaker there, speaker here. Those will be tied in conjunction with the speakers out there in the landscape so that those will be together on a zone. The 4, those will be together on a zone. And then for coverage for the basketball court, we wired it any way possible. We have a speaker here. We have a speaker line at the end of the garage, or I'm sorry, the pool house. Down here, there will not be a speaker here because at this point in time, you know, you're kind of throwing sound at an angle out there, which you could, but it's not going to do a lot for covering. There is a line there in case it's needed. However, where the speaker is going to be, the other speaker that'll be matched up to this, is right there on the side of that house. That's what's going to be matched with the other speaker on the pool house. And as you can see, we'll angle it a little more, but it's nice in line with the basketball court. I'm standing right here in line. If I turn that too quick, pardon me. Come around here, boom. So that's going to definitely provide better coverage with that speaker these two on this basketball court than two on the side of the pool house. So, yeah, drastic change. One other thing I'll show you. These are the conduits here. Not all of these are ours, but some of them are. This is how we're getting wiring into the house, into the basement storage area. How everybody is. Electricity, audio, low voltage for lighting, whatever. That's what's happening. These conduits come through here. Everything is glued because we're using a vacuum to suck the lines through. Before we suck the lines, you put a little plastic bag there. There's plenty of videos on YouTube showing how to do that, but that's the process. Might link one of those in the description. But that comes along here, comes around, and then it went to different areas as you saw in those other videos. So that's the process right now. And by the end of this video, we should see a 65 in that space. We'll be back with you soon. All right, guys, we're on the back of the 65 Terrace. Technically, this is only going to be used for streaming, so here's our internet cable hardwired to it. But we do have two HDMI cables in, one to HDMI 1, one to HDMI 2, which is eARC also. We've got our optical cable. That's what's going to connect to the soundbar. Again, technically, at this point in time, there's no need for these HDMI cables. However, once the bracket goes on and this door closes, you got to take the TV down off the bracket if you want to add or change any cables. So we're putting stuff in now as preventive maintenance, to say the least. So if you ever want to tie anything in HDMI wise, oh, it's already here and just ready to go. So that's that. We're about ready to close this door up and get to the mount. Alright guys, I'll show you one other thing here too. I've got our soundbar brackets going on. Now this is the 65 inch, so we have them matched up right there saying, hopefully it's focusing, but 65, 75, up here it says 50, 55. The point is, even if you have a 55 inch terrace, don't use the 55 hole. We've done that the first time we ever did one of these and realized, hey, with those holes, the soundbar is hanging about 4 inches or so, the top of the soundbar below the bottom of the TV. It looks like crap. So, regardless of what size TV you have, you always use these holes, and it's going to match up. And you're going to have a soundbar at the top of it, nice and even, right about that point, quarter, half inch. The top of the soundbar, quarter half inch from the bottom of the TV. So just an FYI there of what we've run into, and there's the change and the fix. Alright guys, we've got our mount on. We're ready to put the TV up there. Just if you ask, we're using Kanto. That's K-A-N-T-O. We use their mounts, and in this case, this is their outdoor TV mount. So we're going to bring the set up and you'll see it go on that bracket. There we go. Now let's see that drill on the ground. One other thing about this too is for anything like this, we're going to use a full motion mount. We're not going to use just a mount close to the wall because you got to be able to pull the TV out, get behind it if anything were needing to be changed, modified. So you don't want it slim flat against the wall and can't. This needs to go what?
This side needs to go down.
Okay. We're leveling this too while it is.
say when.
Do it.
Good?
Yep.
So what I was getting at there is, we use a full motion mount so that you're going to have the ability to do just this. Easier mounting, more straightforward, better options all around. You can get behind the set when anything needs to be changed. The other thing we did also is, we know what the width is and the height of the TV, but we allow for a 4 to 6, 7 inch opening, 3 to 7 inches on each side of the TV, including the measurement with the soundbar, the height of that. I don't like to have our cabinet right next to the edge of the TV to where you have barely a gap there. Again, getting out behind it, moving things around. So that's just my preference and going to make things easier down the road to service and to use. For instance, our 55 has the cover on it, but I can at least move this out. This one I'll move out as far as I can, but it's going to hit the fridge. But this is what I'm referring to there. Here you see our gap that we have, just to make sure, because if I gave the exact measurements, what if the cabinet builder made it just a little off? And then it's like, okay, it's just nicking the side of the TV. Like, no, we want to see a nice little even space of a few inches, top, bottom, all around. So that, again, you have the ability to get back behind the set, and then you can pull the whole set out. So that's our preference, and that's just going to make serviceability, moving the TV out when you need to, that much more straightforward and easier when that time comes. All right, guys, here you have it. 65 inches in. We're going to put the cover on it here. We turn it off, but it is wired into the home internet, hardwired, not using Wi-Fi. These are these sliding doors we talked about. We've got the sound bar running also. Close it up. Open. So here's our 65. I'll step back a little bit. There's the 55 over there. Again, as you know, it's a full motion mount, so they can pull it out, turn it, push it back, whatever they like. This is the pool house arrangement. And then I'll gaze over to the rest of the pool. And there is their hot tub too, by the way. Playset area, fire pit, about there. And then in here, again with our 65 and 55 Terrace Samsung outdoor TV. All right, keep you updated as this moves along, and we'll be finishing this up not too much farther down the road. All right, guys, Matt Fisher Electronics here. So we're going to close out this video of part one of this outdoor entertainment venture, because it's going to be a little bit, maybe a few weeks or a month until the landscaping is finished behind the pool for our speakers in that playset area, and I'll walk over there, and then the fire pit. So that'll be part two of this video, but I wanted to show you the progress of what we've got. And the system is pretty much completed except for those areas. Four speakers on the side of the house. Those are 6.5 inch. We actually took the existing speakers on the side before, these here, and we moved them to the front of the pool house and added those speakers to the side of the house. that's giving us audio from the side of the house to the pool. This is our front pool, front of the pool house here. The speaker right there, and a speaker right over here. We'll walk over that and show you. Now this is going to be tied in to the two landscape speakers at the back, which are not in yet, obviously, but that's going to be its own group, along with the side of the house, those four speakers being a group. This is in the Sonos system. Two other groups are going to be the fire pit. One other group is going to be the fire pit and the playset, as far as how that's going to operate. Here are our TVs. These are both hardwired into the home.
there's the 65 inch and then there's the 55 inch. Both playing, again, they're hardwired. We're certainly not using Wi-Fi. The Wi-Fi system is a Eero mesh system. We've got a system access point in the house. We've got a unit at our rack, and we've got a unit out here in the storage. I'm not gonna open that up quite yet. I'll get to that in part two, but our storage is in this door right here. Well, I'll at least show you the box, the outside of it. This is where our equipment is, our lines are coming in, our box on the wall, and then our access point for outside for Wi-Fi is in that box. So that is, again, taking care of internet via Wi-Fi and hardwired. Here's his basketball court. That is being, audio is being provided by this speaker right here on the side of the house. I'm sorry, the pool house, I should say. This speaker right here is one providing audio for the basketball court. And then the second one is right here. Watch where I walk here. On the side of the house, providing audio to the basketball court. So then we walk back around. Again, the way the system was designed, we've got conduits going to each TV, one to the 55, one to the 65, for any lines that need to be gotten there, future-proof. We've got Cat 6 cable going to those locations. We've got our audio lines for the pool house going into that storage area. We've got a conduit going to the fireplace. We've got a conduit, I'll walk over there now. And the conduit speaker, sorry, the speaker for the fireplace is going to be right here. Here's our line. We've got another conduit for their playset area over here, which is right over here on the other side of this wall. This is going to be a fabric, big artificial turf or some type of fabric grass laid in here. So we're going to wait and see how that is. It can be moved up and cut to put our speakers in. There's a diving board, and then this is going to be mounted here over on this right side. And that sticking out of the ground is our conduit for the rear speakers back here on the back side of the pool. So lines are run. It's all ready to go. We're just waiting. Give you a panorama from this view. Pool is all in. Covers on, hot tubs in, ready to go. So the system's really coming together at this point. There's a view from that side, and I'll walk that way. Lines are all in, everything's ready to go. The rest of this job is putting the landscape speakers in those areas, backside of the pool, fire pit, and playset. Turning the amp on, getting it wired, and you're rocking and rolling, the system should be finished. Biggest thing that I could say is my suggestion is, if you're doing a project like this, an outdoor entertainment area, whether you're renovating, even in a house, if it's renovating your inside of their house, but in this case, outdoor projects, get a hold of your AV company. If you're in North Central Ohio, contact us, Fisher Electronics, at fisherelectronics.net. That's our website, or 419-668-5131. Contact us in the North Central Ohio area, or your AV electronics company, when you're initially starting your plans, you know, before any ground is broken, because as you can see from these outstanding paver stones and everything, we had to get our conduits in. This is a two-year project. Started last year in spring, early summer, and now we're in spring of the following year, and it's starting to get completed. So the conduit and everything has to go in before any of this is done, if the system is really to be built correctly. You know, if they would have approached us after the fact now and said, oh, by the way, can I get audio to this? Not going to be a fun story or a conversation at that point. So contacting your AV company in the beginning stages is really the best thing to do. Have them come out, do a consultation. We're happy to do that. give you thoughts, give you ideas and proposals to get it all set up and according to what's going to work best for you and the system you're looking for. So I'm going to wrap this video up now for part one. I'll put a link in the description below when part two is completed, and you'll see a little thing in the on the screen here. You know, click here for part two of this to finish the system up. But we're going to wrap this part one up now for this system. It's really come along nicely, and they have a fabulous system here. It's a Sonos operating system with Eero Wi-Fi mesh, and they've got just a great outdoor system for audio and video. Matt, FisherElectronics.net. Visit us there, throw any comments down below, and I'll see you on the next one and for part two of this.